Now we will try to understand how to apply styles to the HTML elements using CSS. So in this session I will try to explain one sample. In this sample I will show you how to apply the styles to the HTML elements using CSS and also by using CSS selectors. So in this sample I will be creating a page with the name studentregistration.html with SID and a text box, that is student ID and a text box, next first name and a text box, next last name of a student and a text box, next states and a drop down list, and similar way I will try to create blood group and a text box and a submit button. So I will try to apply styles to this first control using ID selector, and also for this L name I will be applying the same style. Whatever the style I have applied, I am going to apply for this SID. For last name also I will try to apply the same style by using ID selector. So for this and also for this, same style using ID selector. And similar way I will apply the styles to this fname and to this bg using a CSS class selector. CSS class selector. And I will apply styles to this states drop down list using CSS element selector. And I will apply the style to the submit button control using element and attribute selector. So I believe you understood what I am going to do in this sample. So now let me start writing the code for the HTML file first. After writing the HTML code, I will try to create a CSS file and I will define all the selectors with styles in the CSS file, and I will try to explain how to link the .css file to HTML file. After explaining how to link the .css file with HTML file, so I will explain how to apply the styles which are present in the CSS files to individual elements, so that you can able to understand the overall concept. Now in this sample website I will try to create one HTML page with the name studentregistration.html. So in this file first let me write the code for creating the HTML elements. So you observe here I have written the HTML code for defining the user interface, something like this. So let me use br tags also in appropriate places. I am just defining the br tags so that you can able to see the user interface in appropriate lines. After creating the HTML file code something like this, now let us try to create a CSS file. So let me explain how to create a CSS file now. Right click on your application, click on add, click on add new item, and here you must be able to see a file called as style sheet. What is the extension for this style sheet file? Obviously it is CSS. For CSS file the extension is .css. You are allowed to give any name for the .css file. So in my case I'll use the style sheet file name as myappstyles.css. Let me click on enter. Now you must be able to see the style sheet file something like this. Automatically you will see body tag or body element here. In case if you wanted to apply any specific style to the complete HTML body, you can write the code over here. Maybe I'll write background color, I'll go for yellow color. So automatically when this CSS file is linked with this HTML file, this body will get this background color. Now let me define one ID selector and I will specify some style, and that ID selector styles I will be applying it to this SID and also to this last name. So for SID and L name, same CSS code or same CSS style for this SID as well as LN using ID selector. Now first you tell me what is the SID given for this SID text box. that is TBSID. Now let me write hash TBSID. The same style I would like to apply it for LN text box also. What is ID given for TBLN or for this LN text box? It is TBLN. So I should write hash TBLN. Open curly bracket, end curly bracket. Now let me apply some style. Maybe I'll use background color green. And I'll use normal color. That is font color maybe red. So green red combination. So after this, I will try to define the same style for this first name and for this BG using a CSS class selector. Now let me define a class. How to define a class in CSS? By using a dot. I can give any class name here. So in my case, I am using my class as the class name. Now let me apply background color blue and color maybe white, right? So finally this class style, I will be applying it to this first name text box and to the BG text box. Similar way, I will try to apply this style to this drop down list using CSS element selector. So what is the element name for this drop down list? Element name is select. Now let me use that element name. How to use? Directly the element name, that is select. Open curly bracket, end curly bracket. Now let me write background color. Maybe I'll go for orange color and maybe color, some color. I'll use some hexadecimal color code for this color for the select element. So let me use some color over here, maybe 45 FF12. I don't know which color it will be producing, but I have written some code here. After this, I will apply one more style to this submit button by using element and attribute selector. Let me go to my CSS file, and in the HTML I have written the element name as import and attribute name as type is equals to submit. Let me write input square bracket type is equals to submit. So I am trying to apply this style to this element by using element name and attribute name and including attribute value. So here I am trying to apply this style to this element by using element name input and then attribute name type and the value as submit. So I am using the same thing here. Now let me use background color. Maybe I'll go for aqua color. I don't know what aqua color means. And similar way, I will try to apply color red. So I have written styles over here, something like this in the CSS file. Now we have to link the CSS file with HTML file. So in order to link the CSS file to an HTML file, you should go to the HTML file. Inside the header, you should write link rel is equals to, you should write style sheet, and you should write href is equals to style sheet file name. What is the style sheet file name? myappstyles.css. This is how you will be linking a .css file with the HTML file. Now for applying this element style to this body element, you no need to do anything because we used this element name directly here. Similar way, you are writing some element IDs over here. So whatever the element IDs I have used over here, when this CSS file is linked with this HTML file, automatically whichever the control IDs having this TBSID and TBLN, so for those controls automatically the styles will be applied. I no need to write any extra code here. But if I want to apply this class style to this FN text box and to this BG text box, I should write extra code. What is that extra code? I should write class is equals to, what is the class name? My class. Similar way, for this BG element also, I should write class is equals to my class. That's all. Similar way, I have used select over here. What is this select? This is an element selector. So this select element CSS style will be directly applied to this select element. I no need to do anything over here. Similar way, I have written input type is equals to submit. So again, this is an element and attribute combination. So that style must be applied to this control. So anyhow, for this control, the tag name, the element name is input, and the attribute name value is type is equals submit. Again, I no need to write any extra thing here. Or in simple words, in case if you want to apply any class style to your HTML element, you have to write class is equals to that class name, or otherwise you no need to do any extra thing here. Okay, so I believe you understood. Now after applying the styles and after linking the CSS file to the HTML file, I will try to show this studentregistration.html output in my browser by clicking on view in browser. Now when the HTML file is open in the browser, you must be able to observe the relevant styles to the HTML controls. Now you observe, whatever the styles I have defined in the CSS, so that styles are applied to these controls. So body, for body I have defined yellow color, and for TBSID and TBLN I have used green and red combination. So you must be able to see green and red combination here, right? So similar way for the other elements also, appropriate styles are applied. So I believe you understood. Now the question here is, why this approach is advantageous? Why we must use this approach? That is the CSS approach for applying the styles to the HTML elements. It is simple. Now you assume that this CSS file styles are used in 20 HTML files. Now you assume that this TBSID and TBLN controls are present in 20 HTML files. Now for all the text boxes which are using this SID and LN styles, if I want to change the styles, I have to change it only in one place. Now let me change here. Let me use background color white, and let me use the color as blue. If you observe carefully, in the HTML files I am not making any changes. So I just made changes in CSS file. Now let me click on re-execute. Now you observe, you can able to observe the changes here. So that is the reason why this approach is better approach. So when you use the CSS files for applying styles to the HTML files, you no need to change the CSS style code in multiple locations. So maximum you have to change the CSS file code inside the CSS file only, so that style will be automatically applied to all the HTML controls which are present in the HTML pages. So I believe you understood. And you also remember one important point. In a given website, you are allowed to create any number of CSS files depending on your requirement. In case if I am having one more CSS file here, I can able to link that CSS file also to this HTML file by writing some code, something like this. And if you assume that my second CSS style file name is otherstyles.css, I can write otherstyles.css also here, so that both the CSS files will be linked with HTML. So all what I mean to say here is, you can able to create n number of CSS files in a given website depending on your requirement. I believe you understood.